Relation between angular acceleration and linear acceleration. Acceleration of a particle, that is object, A is equal to limit delta t tends to 0 delta v upon delta t. A is equal to dv by dt. But v is equal to r omega, therefore A is equal to d by dt r omega is equal to r d omega upon dt plus omega dr by dt. Because r is constant and dr by dt is 0, therefore A is equal to r d omega by dt. Because d omega by dt is alpha, therefore A is equal to r alpha. By definition, A bar is equal to A bar t plus A bar r, where A bar t is the tangential component of linear acceleration, AR bar is the radial component of linear acceleration, and A bar is the linear acceleration. In UCM, omega is equal to constant, therefore alpha bar is equal to d omega bar by dt is equal to 0 bar, therefore A bar is equal to AR bar as AT is equal to 0. Thus, in UCM, linear acceleration is centripetal acceleration. So, magnitude of acceleration A is equal to under root AT square plus AR square. Centripetal and centrifugal forces. 1. Centripetal force. Circular motion is an accelerated motion, and this acceleration is along the radius directed towards the center of the circle. According to Newton's second law of motion, this acceleration must have been produced by some force acting in the direction of acceleration, that means along the radius and directed towards the center of the circle. This force is called centripetal force. The centripetal force is necessary for circular motion to occur, that means it is the centripetal force which always maintains the circular motion of the particle. Since centripetal force acts as right angles to the tangential velocity of particle, there is no displacement in the direction of force, and hence no work is done by centripetal force. As per Newton's second law of motion, force is equal to mass into acceleration. Here FCP is equal to MA, but A is equal to V omega is equal to V square upon R is equal to R omega square. Therefore FCP is equal to mv omega, that is equal to mv square upon r is equal to mr omega square. In vector notation, fcp bar is equal to minus mv square upon r, r cap is equal to minus m omega square r bar. Then centrifugal force. We know that Newton's laws of motion are true in such a frame of reference which is fixed or which is moving with constant linear velocity relative to a fixed frame. On the other hand, Newton's laws of motion are not true in accelerated frame of reference. Newton's laws of motion can be made applicable to the motion of an object in an accelerated frame of reference by assuming the existence of one or more fictitious forces acting on the object. In fact, such forces are not real forces as they arise due to the acceleration of the frame of reference. Such forces are called pseudo forces. For example, let a body of mass m be placed on a smooth circular table which itself is kept rotating with a uniform angular velocity, that is, uniform circular motion. Let r be the distance of the body from the axis of rotation and v be its linear velocity. If the frictional force between the body and the table is not sufficient, the body must be tied at the center of the table by some string. Now, a person standing outside and looking at the rotating table will see that the body is rotating. He will observe a centripetal force mv square upon r acting on the body. Obviously, this force is provided by the tension in the string, and it is a real force acting on the body. But to the person standing on the table, the body appears to be at rest. This is because the position of the body does not change with respect to him. Hence, from the viewpoint of the person, there should not be any force acting on the body. But the body is acted upon by a real centripetal force of magnitude mv square upon r directed towards the center. Hence, according to the person on the table, a force of magnitude mv square by r must act outwards, that is, in the direction opposite to that of centripetal force, so that the net force on the body is zero. This apparent outward force is referred to as centrifugal force. Of course, the centrifugal force is an apparent force and its effect is clearly observed by the man standing on the table. Suppose the string tied to the body is cut. Then to a person standing on the ground, the body moves in tangential direction to the circular path. And suppose the same event is seen by the man standing on the table, to him, the body appears to be moving radially outwards. We know that uniform circular motion is an accelerated motion and therefore a particle performing this motion is in an accelerated frame of reference. Hence, a pseudo force acts on the particle, which is centrifugal force. The magnitude of the centrifugal force is same as that of the centripetal force, but its direction is opposite to that of the centripetal force. Thus, in magnitude and direction, the centrifugal force is given by F bar is equal to mv square upon r, r0 bar is equal to m omega square r bar, where r0 bar is the unit vector in the direction of r bar.